What's up, everybody? How are you all doing? TryHackMe released this new bruteforce activedirectory box, and I'm going to walk you guys through it. So let's just get to it. I already started the box, and here we have a domain controller, which we have to compromise by exploiting kerberos authentication and navigating through SMB shares, performing passive sparying, and utilizing pass the hash techniques to get to the domain controller. Cool. Okay. I'll first connect to TryHackMe VPN. And I'm going to make a directory for the CTF, soupedecode.local. I'm going to run our, I added the domain name and the directory name. Okay. I'm going to run the nmap basic scan on the IP and see what do we have here. I already ran the netexec to list the shares, but we're going to do it again. Don't worry. So here we have DNS port open as a RPC, SMB, and we got RDP open, we got the Kerberos port open, and we got LDAP stuff. Okay, so till the nmap completes, let's see if we can list the shares using null authentication, shares, and we'll go from there. Okay, so we see it's a Windows Server 2022, and we got the domain controller at DC01 and the domain soupedecode.local, but we can't list shares using null authentication. So let's see if we can, we have guest access on, and we see if we can list the shares using guest account without no password. Okay, looks like we can authenticate using guest and no password. So we're gonna be able to list the shares on the network, and I think nmap is about to be complete. Okay, we got the shares back, and we see a backup share. We got read access on IPC, that's just basic inter-process communication, use the list shares, connect to the SMB, and all the basic stuff. We got a user share, okay, but we don't have any read or write permissions on them. So let's go back to our nmap for now. We got the basic DNS, Kerberos on port 88, and we got NetBIOS running, LDAP, and other stuff. We got RDP running on 3389, and we got our domain, soup. Decode.local and domain controller at DC01. I think I'll need to delete the last entry while I was doing the box for the first time. And we can add our new entry using set IP. It's an alias that I use. I can add soupedecode.local. Soupedecode.local, yep. And I also gotta add the domain controller. There we go. I need to go to the last of the line. What are you doing? There we go. DC01.soupedecode.local. There we go. And now let's get back to our SMB shares. So next thing we're gonna do is enumerate our IDs. Basically, that will give us the usernames of the on the domain that exists, and we're gonna bruteforce the password for the users. So there we go. There are a couple of other ways that we can do. We can use, I think, for bruteforcing, we can use kerbrute too, or I think we can also use Hydra, but I don't have Hydra in my box, so we're going to use netexec and kerbrute to do it. Okay, so there are a lot of users on the box, but we're interested in these SID type user, because that's what we need. And if we go above, the 500 RID is usually administrator account, and I'm going to copy from here. Or we can just copy from like down below. There we go. How many users are there? God damn. Okay, there we go. Okay, we had a couple of others, but okay, let's just copy the whole thing. Can we go above? Dude. 4444. Go up. My Tmux is acting weird. There we go. There we go. So I'm going to copy up to 500 and I'm going to put it into a file called rids.txt. So we can filter out just the usernames, rids. We're going to cut the, put the delimiter to backslash, and we're going to print out the fill number 2. So we only get the, you know, the username or the machine account name, and we're gonna use another cut command to remove the SID type user. We're gonna print the fill number 1. There we go. Now we can save it into users.txt. We can remove the guest account, the domain, the cert. We don't need these. Couple others. There we go. Now it's looking fine. So what are we gonna do next? We're gonna password spray. You have mentioned password spraying, so we're gonna password spray, or you can say bruteforce user accounts, and see if we can crack into someone's account, right? We're gonna use netexec smb soup decod.local, and we're gonna pass the user's word list and the users, and we're also gonna pass the same word list as passwords. Maybe someone is using their username as their password, right? It's a CTF, we gotta think like that, okay. And we're gonna use no bruteforce, so it don't actually spray password, right? It's just, you know, you take the first username here and put the password here, so we can, you know, just basically test that. And I think that's all we need to do here. There we go. We can also use kerbrute to do this, but always make sure you use a dash V with the kerbrute. And if you press enter, we're gonna use password spray command with kerbrute. Password spray, and if I press enter again, we need to specify user as pass, the same thing that we are doing here, testing the username as the password, you see. So we can do this with kerbrute too. So other thing we need to pass is DC, it's DC01, the domain controller, soupdecode.local, and we need to pass the domain, soupdecode.local, there we go. And we need to pass the user's word list. Okay, users.txt. And we also need to pass the passwords. I think we just passed this, so we don't need to pass the password file. And always make sure you use it with dash V, the kerbrute. There we go. It's pretty fast in the netexec, but yeah. So it's completed, and we got a username that's using the same password. So I can stop the kerbrute, and we got the same output with the kerbrute. There we go. So next thing, now we have a valid credentials, right? So let's see if we can list any shares using those credentials. Soupedecode.local, and it's this user, the password, and let's see if we can list any shares using these valid credentials on the box. Okay. And we are successfully authenticated, and let's see if we have any read write access to any share and move on from there, right? And now we can also perform kerberoasting because now we have a valid credential on the domain. But let's see. So we got read access on the user share, so we can now use impacket-smbclient to authenticate to the SMB share and navigate the file system basically. So we can use soupdecode.local and our user credentials. There we go, and we can pass again the domain name. There we go. And now we can use help if you don't know how to navigate through it, or we can just use shares to list the shares. And we know we got read access on user shares, so I'm gonna use that. We gotta use users. And now we can do ls, and we got ybob317. There we go. And now we can just cd into the desktop and grab our user flag. There we go, user.txt, and I think we're done with this share right now. We can check if we have the user.txt. There we go. So next thing we're gonna do, now we have valid credentials, right, that we talked earlier, now we can perform kerberoasting. So let me try to explain kerberoasting to you guys. xkellydraw.com, and we're gonna do it nice and simple way, and there we go. So let's see, I'm gonna use the pencil here. There we go. So imagine we have a service account, right? Imagine we have a service account, right? It could be anything. It could be basically HTTP or anything. And this is the Active Directory or whatever you wanna say, kerberoasting or anything. And it has an SPN set. The service account has an SPN set. SPN is basically service principal name, and what we service principal name is basically like a unique identifier. How do you spell principal? Yeah, there we go. So service principal name is like a unique identifier that tells Kerberos that this account is running a specific service in activedirectory. That's all SPN is. And if a service account has an SPN set as a low authenticated user that has low privileges or anything, we can request a TGS ticket from the server. So when we request a TGS ticket for a specific SPN, it will return the TGS ticket encrypted with that service account's NTLM hash password. And as an attacker, we can grab that ticket from the memory and crack it locally using John the Ripper and Hashcat. That's as simple as it is. So we can use impacket-GetUserSPNs for this, and we can press enter to see what options do we have. We can specify the domain, the local, and we can specify our low privilege user with the valid credentials, and we can specify a request because we need to request a TGS ticket, and it will output them in John the Ripper Hashcat format for us to crack it later. And we're gonna use a user's file to specify the users to test it against, basically. And we're gonna also specify the DCIP here. And can we just specify the domain? Because I have to copy the IP. There we go. So what it will do, basically, it will request a TGS ticket using our valid credentials of YBOB user, and it will request a TGS for our service, right, for SPN. And if there is an SPN set for a service account, it will return its TGS. And there you go. So we got TGS for file SVC service account on this box. So now we can crack this ticket using Hashcat or John the Ripper, and we'll be able to crack the NTLM hash password for this service account. There you go. We're going to use John the Ripper to crack it and solve the challenge, solve the box, basically. I hope you guys understand kerberoasting. It's super simple, not too complex topic. It's very basic attacks and activedirectory. And there we go. We cracked the password for a file SVC account. Now we can use SMB to check if we have any elevated privileges on the box. Usually we do, because these service accounts have some specific privileges on the box. And now we can use file SVC with the password we got. We need to wrap it in single quotes or double quotes, so it, the command line don't, you know, think of them as, what do you want to say? Think of them as arguments. My bad. My brain is just spinning right now. Okay, so we authenticated successfully, and let's see if we have any more access on any other share or so. Previously, we only had read access on user share. So let's see what do we have with file SVC account. So now we have read access on backup share. So we can authenticate again using SMB client. And there we go. Local file SVC. We can specify the password here. And again, pass the domain. There we go. Name or service not known. Oh, I forget the E here. Again, I forgot the E here too. My bad, guys. And now we're logged in. So we can use a backup share and list files. What do we have? We got backup extract.txt. So we can get that file, control D, get out of it, and cat it and see what do we have. So we got NTLM hashes for different machine accounts, and again we can use netexec to brute force, or to just check which one is a valid combination. Again, we need to first extract these account names. Delimiter, we need to use colon, and let's extract the field one, and we're gonna save it in machines.txt. Now we can extract the field number 4 for the NT hash. And we're gonna save it in hashes.txt. Now we can use netexec to do the same thing we did with the users. Machines.txt, and for the hashes we need to use -H and hashes.txt. And we're gonna use no brute force. There we go, and that's it. And let's see which one is valid one, and we'll go on from there. Hmm. the trick server. So there you go. We found a valid endLM hash and the username combination. So we got the endLM hash for file server account, and you see this font? It means it has administrator access, or like we have access on the server. It's basically pwned. That's what it means. So we can check it. Soupedecode.local. We need to use file server with the endLM hash. Oh, I need to copy the hash. And let's list the shares. There we go. Oh, I need to, I think, use dollar sign here because it's a machine account and it's not running. What the heck? Oh, my bad. My bad, guys. Again, type this wrong. So stupid. There we go. We can authenticate as guest. I've removed the dollar sign. We need to use that because it's a machine account, and machine accounts are identified as a dollar sign at the end of their name. Now we can authenticate it. There we go. Now we see the pwned, and let's see what access do we have on the shares or the machine basically, and we'll pretty much have redirect access on admin C share. And that's pretty much game over. Next, we can use psexec, wmiexec, or if we had winrm, we can use that. So let's see. You see, we have redirect access on admin share, c-share, and others too. So now we can use psexec. So I was again typing it wrong. My bad. Local file server. Dollar sign, and that's it. We can specify the hashes using this, and we need to specify the domain again here, decode.local. There we go. So impacket psexec will just spin up a service in one of the SMB share. You see it found a writable share. It's spinning up this exe file, like basically a background service that will give us a shell as anti-authority system on the box. Opening SSC manager, creating a service, starting the service, and we'll have our shell right here as anti-authority system. We are anti-authority system with the highest privilege on a domain controller. So we can just now go to C users administrator. I'm typing it all wrong. Administrator. Go to the desktop, and we can now grab the root.txt and be done with the box. That was a box, and I hope you guys learned something new. We saw how to exploit kerberoastable users and crack their TGS ticket, and we saw how to navigate through different SMB shares using impacket-smbclient. We performed password spraying using kerbrute and NXC, and we also utilized pass the hash technique with psexec and also the SM, which one was it? The netexec, basically the dash capital H. And I hope you guys really learned something new. And if you have any doubts or queries, you can always text me on Discord. And I'll see you guys till next time. Goodbye.